watching Jeddah TV, family television with power.
Jesus is the way.
Hi, I'm Ernest Johnson. I am the pastor of the Jesus is the Answer Apostolic Church, World Television Ministries, the Jeddah Television Network on in Los Angeles or Southern California and online. And I'm also the president of the RUSH Revival Crusades International, amen, which is an international evangelistic traveling ministry reaching hundreds of thousands around the United States and in some countries. And I'm here to tell my story.
So my name is Pastor Raymond Kennedy. I'm an associate pastor here at Jesus is the Answer. I had a lot going on in my life, and my brother introduced me to Bishop because we never knew anything about prophets or anything like that. We knew about psychics, but this was like a whole different experience. So my brother was like, you have to meet this man, you have to meet this man. So I end up meeting him on the night that my Jerry Springer show aired. I remember him prophesying a lot of things in my life that was already happening. There was one key moment that he told me about that nobody else was around, and I knew at that point that God was talking to him about me. The ending of that is that I got filled with the Holy Ghost in 1998 in the middle of my brother's living room, and he prophesied to me, if I didn't stop what I was doing, then of course the end result of that would be death. I promise you I could go on and on and on, but the one thing that I really want to say is I'm so glad that God put this man in my life. If it wasn't for the way God used Bishop, I probably wouldn't be saved today.
My name is Antoine Caribbean. You know, I've been in the church, I would say about almost 7 years. I've been knowing the pastor about 7 years. And I met him, you know, a good while ago, and shared a few things, and I came and got saved. And I noticed as I've been going to church more and more that he's really holy, really, when he says the word, he does the word. He is, you know, not is the word, but he walks it. Walks it and talk it. Pretty good. The church, Jesus is the Answer. The church, you know, great church, small church, like a family. It's wonderful. You know, the church is wonderful. The church is, it's all about saving souls. And with this pastor, Bishop Ernest Johnson is saving souls.
My name is Brother Dale Wendell Scott. My whole life changed dramatically because, as I had said before on a different interview a while back, and said I was on a suicide mission and I wanted to kill every one of my enemies one by one. But I thank God for His grace and His mercy working through Bishop Ernest and doing, being faithful in the ministry and carrying on. Not only me, but there was about 10 of us. We all gathered together, we jumped in the van. He'd come in the van sometimes, pick us up, or he'll come on his bike. He had a two-seater bike, one of those double-seated bikes, and he'll pick one of us up and take us to church. So that we were here, and he didn't care how old you were, he just wanted you to go and hear the word of God. And I thank God for that.
One night my pastor asked me if I could speak at a youth service. I told him I'd never spoke before, I've never preached or did anything like that. And nevertheless, I was obedient to him and I got up to speak, and all of a sudden I felt this big bucket of water hit me from the top of my head down to the sole of my feet. And I just started preaching. I didn't know what I was preaching. I can't tell you to this day, but I just started preaching. I preached for about 20 or 30 minutes. And then after I got through preaching, I'm like, what happened? And it was the anointing of the Holy Ghost that had fallen upon me to preach. Once I started preaching, I had to develop, and you know, I developed under my pastor, and I went to Sunday school, I went to Bible studies. Those became more important to me than the actual Sunday morning service. Sunday morning service was where I could bring people in to get saved. But Bible study and Sunday school was the place that I would go because I was aching and yearning to know the Word of God. I wanted an understanding of what it was God wanted me to do.
Praise the Lord. My name is Dorothy Smith. Bishop Ernest Johnson is my bishop. He's my pastor also. Jesus is the Answer is my church home. And I've been in this church for maybe 35 or more years. And Bishop is actually the reason why I'm here in this ministry. The fact is, I watched him as a young kid growing up in the neighborhood at the time. I also met his mother, Mary, who was raising him and three other siblings. Bishop was the oldest, no, he had older brother, Robert, and there was Bishop. There was a sister, Debbie, and a brother, Nate. He was an inspiration in my life because each time that in my life that I would go to church and see him still there in church, it just inspired me more to want to be there in church and be more like him, because it was a big difference with him and the people in the world who I was dealing with. And I actually made up my mind through him to be saved by wanting to be like him, because he was an inspiration to me. And that's how I became saved, by following him.
My name is Michael Brown. I've been knowing PJ, not Ernest. I've been knowing PJ since I was, 13 years old? My experience is that he came into me and my brother's life at a time where our father was incarcerated for murder. And it was just so crazy how I know that God is, you know, have something special for me and my brother, or calling on our life, or had his hand on our life. Because, you know, when my father went to jail, I think maybe 1 or 2 months later, my brother met PJ, and then eventually I met him. And then towards, you know, my father's sentence, towards a year maybe of knowing PJ, he asked my brother one night, "What do you want from God?" And my brother said, "I want my father home." And I remember that night, it was me, PJ, my brother, and Kiwan. We went to the church and my brother got baptized that night. And my brother spoke in tongue at, I think, about 12 or 13 years old. And the next week, my father was home in the flesh. And I just want to say thank you, PJ, for always being there, for being a father to me and my brother. I mean, just really being there, man, teaching me how to groom myself as a young man and how to talk to God and how to appreciate God. Because without you, Pastor, I would have never knew anything about God. And I'm alive to this day, Pastor, because God sent you. You know, when God took my father in that murder case and he went away, you know, everything happens for a reason, you know, but it was to get me and my brother to know him. And I just thank everybody that God put in my life at the time when I met you. Thank you, PJ.
It was one New Year's Eve, I'll never forget, my overseer, Evangelist Clara Woodson from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, was here for the New Year's Eve watch service. And anybody that knows anything about the New Year's Eve watch service, there's a lot of shooting going on, and the church that we were in was an aluminum building. It was like an aluminum patio building that they had converted into the church. I'll never forget, we were down praying, and all of a sudden we could hear the bullets hit the top of the roof of the building at where we were at. And I jumped up, you know, kind of jumped up out of fear. And my overseer jumped up, and when I jumped up into a trance. And as I was in the trance, I could hear the words in my mind, "Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature." And it just kept, I kept hearing that in my mind. And then when I opened my eyes, my overseer was standing straight across from me, and she said, "The Lord is talking to you." And she said, "What is he saying to you?" And I opened my mouth, he said, "Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature." And then she said to me, "You do that and the Lord will bless you."
My name is Dolores, and I met Ernie when he was young. He was about 14, 15.
It was when Jesus' answer was over at Mother Janet's house. They were having church at her house, and I met Ernie because he knew my son, Kerry. Me and Kerry, they got kind of close, and they didn't run together, but Ernie's lived with his foster mother, and at times they would go out, you know, to McDonald's with his kids, and he would get like a limousine, have Miss Mary get him a limousine, and he'd come by in the limousine and pick Kerry up, and sometimes they would go like just to McDonald's, and sometimes they just rode to Hollywood in that limousine. When Kerry come home, I would ask him like, where did y'all go? And he said, oh, we went to Hollywood. Sometime I would say, where did y'all go? Oh, we just went to McDonald's. McDonald's in a limousine? And I say, what that boy do? He say, his mother gets in that limousine, mama. I used to bring my mother to Jesus' ass was over on Atlantic in Compton. We'd go to two, sometimes three churches a Sunday. But we'd always come to Ernie. He was at the Ison on the Cape Russ for his church. And then we brought our brother Terry in, and Terry, I forget what year that was, but I believe it was in the 80s. And he was baptized at Jesus' Answer over on Atlantic. And Pastor Johnson baptized Terry. I put myself under the leadership of Bishop Ernest Johnson. That's how I came to this church. The rest is history.
He was like funny cat, but he, you know, he tricked a lot of his friends. They make him think that he was like a movie star. He'd have his stepmom, Rennie Moore, go and take him, pick him up, take him riding around through Hollywood, and they go drop him off at Willowbrook Junior High School. In the evening time, he'd come pick him up and take him, you know, take him places. Get up there in Hollywood, and he, you know, got to meet Todd Bridges. You know, he's a good guy though, you know. But one thing he did, he liked it, this vanity. He loved it. He was in love with vanity. That was his girl, but, you know, it was like, she wasn't for him and he wasn't for her. You know, but they were two different people. Ernest today is a preacher. Back then, Ernest then was Ernest, trying to find his way in whatever he was going to be. Either the movie star or the preacher. That's what that is.
So he was more Hollywood
back then? Yeah, more Hollywood back then, yeah.
My name is Carlos Carabee, and I've been knowing Bishop Johnson about 4+ years now. My brother was going to church before me, and he was telling me, you gotta come to church. You know, Bishop, he's special, you know. He's got a real anointing on him. And I finally, one day, I called my brother and I said, I think I'm gonna come to church today. And I came to church and was listening to the message and stuff. It was good, you know, it made a lot of sense. And I was in the process of turning my life around. Bad habits, you know what I mean? Well, let me back it up a little bit. You know, I used to think when people were falling out in church and, you know, shaking and doing all this and Holy Ghost, all of that, I thought it was fake, right? That's my, just, you know, because I wasn't in church. I said, oh, they're faking this and that or whatever. You know, they just want money or whatever, you know, donation and all that. But he put hands on me and I couldn't stop crying. I was shaking, I was crying, I couldn't stop crying. And I knew people were surrounding me in front of the altar. And so I heard somebody say, oh, he's washing him. He's cleaning him, you know. I couldn't stop crying. And he put hands on me again. I hit the floor. I mean, they didn't let me just drop, you know. I guess it was the Holy Spirit or whatever just calmed me down, you know, and finally, I opened my eyes and they picked me up. But that's when I knew it's real. It's definitely real.
Hi, my name is Bernard. I'm a deacon here at the church. Pastor Johnson, when I met him, it was Pastor Johnson at that time. This was some time ago because he did the ceremony for my brother and his wife, and that was probably over 30 years ago. At that time, he told me I had running in my feet, and I didn't know what that meant. Then I bumped into him again years later, out in the world for some time, bumped into him again. I could honestly say that if it wasn't for Ernest Johnson, I don't know where I would be right now because I wanted to get up and run. I didn't want to be a deacon of the church, you know, but he helped me to keep my feet planted. You know what I mean? He did everything he could to get me to stay seated. And then over time, it was very beneficial. He's a good man, good-hearted man.
At the age of 19, I had an unfortunate situation where my pastor had backslidden and he ran off with a 14-year-old girl. And it was devastating to myself, it was devastating to his wife, and it was devastating to the community because I had brought a lot of people into the church, and it was a shock. And so when he left, I turned to Mother Janice, who was my church mother, which was his wife, and I said, what are we gonna do now? And she said, we're gonna go on. She said, tomorrow night, you'll start teaching Bible study, and you'll pastor the church. But I went to God and I said, God, I don't wanna be a pastor that brings shame to your name. You know, got a bunch of women on the side, drinking, getting drunk, doing all that. I want to be holy. I want to represent Christ, and I don't want to bring no shame to your name. So he gave me a dream that I was in a bathroom, clean white bathroom, standing with a bunch of kids around me, and I had a robe on, and my robe was white and glowing, and all the kids were telling me, some said, I'm going to be Elijah, I'm going to be John the Baptist, I'm going to be, you know, whoever. So after everybody named who they were, they all looked at me and said, who are you going to be? And I said, I'll be Jesus. And what that meant is that I would be the leader. I would be the teacher. And at that point, I accepted my calling to pastor a church. And that was the birth of the Jesus is the Answer Apostolic Church.
Hey, my name is Minister Janice Weeks. To get to know Bishop Johnson, when I got here, the Lord told me this is where he wanted me to be. Now, I came from a big apostolic church, but see, the Lord was showing me that ministry need to be, you know, more ministry at the church. So I had a lot of often experience because, you know, I was working on the baptism and also I had worked on the altar. So I began to, you know, look and observe, you know, at the church, and I see what things to be needed, and I start, you know, purchasing a lot of stuff. And so when Bishop approached me, he asked me to be over the baptism. So I was over the baptism for like 4 years. So I had a lot of, you know, formats. They needed forms and stuff and clothes, and I did a lot of, you know, training. Since I've been here, you know, it been a pleasure to get to know Bishop Johnson. And show that, you know, he shows love. He's with you. He supports you. And we have a closeness, and I love that about Bishop Johnson.
I'm Elder Gary Grabney. My bishop happens to also be my son-in-law. So we have a history. When I first came to this church, I knew I came to the right place. I automatically clicked with the bishop, and it took me about 2 weeks to come into church. Everything left me. I had no desires for drinking anymore, doing drugs, going out. Couldn't even think about having a drink. It just left me. Soon after baptized me, when I came up, I was speaking in tongues. I was saved. I've been saved ever since. And it's just been a glorious life for me. I've been blessed over and over and over again in this church. Would never leave it.
Okay, my name is Blanca Lego. I'm a minister here at Jesus is the Answer, part of the finance committee, and the leader of the praise team. My first meeting with Bishop Ernest Johnson was in 1996. I was a drug addict, a real bad drug addict, and we were making speed in our garage, and our house got raided up in the desert. So when I came to live with my sister in West Covina, she was going to church, and I went with her up until about November. And I was at my wit's end. I wanted to die, having a bad time. I had the flu, coming down real heavy. Nobody wanted to give me anything because I had nothing. He came to pray for my sister's house, and I went out there just to be respectful. I had a robe on. I was sick, really sick. My body hurt. He came up and he stopped and he rebuked the devil. And I felt everything just lift off of me. Like in that moment, I felt everything lift off of me. And I was in my right mind all of a sudden. So the power of God flowed through my bishop. You know, and since then, ever since then, I have been running no drugs. Thank the Lord Jesus, no smoking pot. God has delivered me. He refilled me with the Holy Ghost, saved my soul, and here I am today. And Bishop Ernest Johnson, he is one of my best friends. You know, he's a great man of God. He's been there every step of the way whenever I've needed prayer, whenever I've needed help in anything. He's always been there as a friend, as my pastor, and brother-in-law.
My name is Renita Fiji. My experience with Bishop Ernest Johnson is that he's a good pastor. He loves souls. He's very patient. He's very loving and kindly. He'll pray you through anything you're going through. He's basically raising me up and showing me the right way to go and the right way to walk, and basically giving me opportunity to go forth in my ministry with music or preaching or getting me ready to even, you know, be over the youth. The first time I met Bishop Ernest Johnson, I was excited because I was like, there's a pastor that's on fire for God. And I was excited. He came to, at this time, this church I was going to, and he preached. And at that time, I was really seeking God and in my word. And everything I already had talked to somebody about was already confirmed. He came to preach that day. So, and I was excited to meet the man of God.
My name is Kevin Darnell Patton, and basically my experience with Ernest Johnson is I was one of his foster kids that grew up in one of his homes that he had. Basically, I was one that used to run the television ministry, and I used to do editing at the house. I met him at another group home, and I just somehow seemed to stood out, and he accepted me into his foster home. And staying there, he told me about God and being saved and stuff like that. I decided to be saved. And what made me want to be saved is the testimonies and experience, because I used to travel with the pastor and his cameraman, and seeing the testimonies that were coming through, like the revelations of people were saying when he used to pray for people and tell them exactly what I see them getting. And but I've always have called him. He's always checked up on me. You know, he's been a good foster dad, you know. A pastor, minister, someone that I can call on in the middle of the night. He always answers.
My name is Cameron Harris. My experience with Bishop Ernest Johnson is, I guess, about 3 years ago, in 2016, I just moved to California, and I was working with a woman, Cleo, who he works with, and Jita TV, and she put me in contact with him, and I've been working with him in, you know, several different capacities.
Oh, why'd you decide to like work for him?
Initially, because I needed some money and I needed some experience in the field that I want to get into, which is video production and television and film production. And I was actually surprised to meet him and know he actually does know a lot about the business. He's been in it a long time. He knows what he's talking about, and he's just, he's a good resource to have.
My name is David Johnson. My experience with my dad is pretty good. He's nice, kind. He knows how to make me laugh for a long time. Whenever I'm hungry, he'll buy me food. He took me and my sister's Universal, and he spent like a lot of money on us.
So he's a good dad?
Yeah, he spends a lot of money on us. He cares for us.
You love him?
Yeah.
My name is Sister Tanya, and my experience with Bishop goes back 30 years. I met Bishop 30 years ago
and I was living in a one-bedroom apartment with two little bitty kids, and I was in a state of depression. I was watching TV one day, and I came across this gospel channel, Channel 40. And so the guy told me, just off the TV, said, baby doll, you take those pills, you're going to lift your eyes up in hell. And so I repented, and I gave myself to Jesus. That guy told me to find a Bible-based church. So I said, okay. The next day I went and picked my daughter up from school, and she said, mama, we should go to that church right there, because the church was open and the brothers in there was cleaning it up for church that evening or whatever. So I said, okay, and we went, and it just so happened to be Jesus Is the Answer Bishop Church. And so we went, it was Sunday, and we went, and so he led me, he guided me, he counseled me, you know, he counseled my kids. They grown, my kids are grown now. My daughter is 35 and my son is 30, and Bishop has been in their life and also mine, and they have come through with the victory of God because we had a solid teacher, and that was Bishop. And I love God, I love him, and I love God, but I thank God for his anointing that keeps me grounded, you know. Oh, and his word, he teaches the word, and it helps me, you know, to stay grounded. So that's how I met him 30 years ago.
Good morning, my name is Raymond Franklin. My experience with Bishop Ernest Johnson is quite incredible. I mean, we go back some years. Met him with an after-school program, Woodcraft Rangers, in Carver Middle School down in Los Angeles. And signed up, did a little acting, and had a commercial experience. I'm associated with Bishop Ernest Johnson as his primary drummer. And, you know, it's incredible. Had some wonderful experiences, had a chance to travel and, you know, tour, and yeah, enjoy the life.
Well, here I am 40 years later, and I'm still pastoring the Jesus Is the Answer Apostolic Church. This is my 40th year in ministry and pastoring, and we have established over 43 chapters of this ministry in Southern California and around the United States, and we have over 200 to 300 ministers that have been trained here that are working in other churches and helping other people. And we are continuing the work of the gospel of Jesus Christ to tell the world that Jesus is the answer as we reach out to lost souls all over the globe. God bless you.
Praise the Lord, this is Bishop Ernest Johnson inviting you to come to a miracle move of God this Sunday morning at the Jesus Is the Answer Apostolic Church. We're located at 25100 South Normandy Avenue in Harbor City, California. Come on out if you need healing, you need deliverance, you need to be saved, you need to be baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost. I want to invite you to come on out to the Jesus Is the Answer Apostolic Church, 25100 South Normandy Avenue in Harbor City, California. Join us this Sunday morning at 11 a.m. and Bible study is Tuesday at 7:30 p.m. Come on out and we'll see you there.
You're watching Jira TV, family television with power.